Hi, I'm Dr. Garcia. Many of my patients have undergone a cold STEMI heart attack procedure, and people have asked me about that, and I'm finishing up here in my office this afternoon. And so what we're going to do is basically go through the process of what happens to you when you start having a heart attack. What's going to happen after you finish this part of this tape is I'm going to pull this stopwatch, and what this will show is the time it takes to get from point A. We're going to go to a point here in Houston and drive to the hospital through the emergency room to the cath lab, and I'm going to take a model. In fact, once you show, let's pick up the model here. I'm going to pick up one of these models of a heart and show what happens when I do this procedure called cold STEMI, a heart cath, and open up the artery in a patient who's having a heart attack. So we're going to get in the car and suburban and drive to a spot in Houston, which is a place, and the traffic's pretty bad, so this will give you an idea how long it takes when you start experiencing chest pain. It'll take you to get to the hospital and to go through what we're about to proceed with.
Yeah. Okay, we're here on Memorial Drive in Houston. Say you're driving home or driving to work or whatever, a cold front's just come in, and so it's pretty cold and it's rainy, the traffic's heavy. You know, you might be under stress, and all of a sudden you start having chest pain. And it's very severe chest pain with maybe a little queasiness, nauseated, you're not feeling well, you get a little bit of sweatiness, maybe it's radiating here to your shoulder. So what you do is you reach for some aspirin, and you just open, you always carry aspirin in the car, and you take two aspirin, put it in your mouth, chew it, let the particles get under your tongue, and this is what we're going to do. We're going to drive to the hospital from Memorial and Willcrest, and we're going to go to the emergency room, and it's already started, kind of like 60 minutes. You know, we'll show you how long it takes you to drive there. And then once we get to the hospital, I'll also show you where you'll go in the emergency room and to the cath lab. So the next shot you're going to see is us going into the emergency room. Ready? Okay, so we have just come off Willcrest, and we're driving west on Westheimer here in Houston. And this is the heart, the model of the heart. We're about ready to make a left-hand turn here to the hospital. And I've got my stopwatch here, and it shows it's taken me roughly 9 minutes to get to this point. I'm just going to assume, if you look at this model, that it's this artery here in front. I'm driving in traffic, so I'm just going to kind of show you it's that artery. We're just going to assume it's the left anterior descending artery, or the artery to the front of your heart, that's blocked. And I'm going to be making a left-hand turn here in a couple of minutes. Okay, we've made a left-hand turn on the West Houston Medical Center Boulevard, and Mr. Evansio, if you show them the hospital over there. That's the hospital. And whenever you come to the hospital, if you don't know the hospital where the emergency room is, just follow the signs. And as soon as you get to this corner, you just follow the signs to the emergency room. Zero in on the sign, and I'll be talking. Did you get it? Okay, great. Now, as you can see, it's been 15 minutes, you see there?
Mm-hmm.
It's been 15 minutes since I took the aspirin at the corner of Willcrest and Memorial. I drove here to the West Houston Hospital. I asked Don Smith, and this is Don Smith, who's here at the front. Just say hi to everybody.
Hi, everybody.
And so I would have told her I had chest pain. You bring me in here, and we do an EKG. And how long does the EKG take?
Less than five minutes.
Okay, so, and if it shows a heart attack, if it's a left anterior descending heart attack, then you call a cold STEMI
immediately.
And so now from here, we're going to go to the cath lab, and we'll start filming in the cath lab. All right, so now you can see we're The Times says, what do you see there, Mr. Garcia?
15 minutes?
Well, it looks more like 18 minutes. So from the time I left, oh, here comes your minister. The time I left the corner of Willcrest and Memorial, took us 18 minutes to get here. And so from the emergency room, I'm now in the cath lab. And this is the table where we put all our instruments. And let's pretend like this is your heart right here. And it'll be right here. And I'm going to be inserting the catheters and the wires and the stent to the heart to open up and stop the heart attack. And so the quicker you get to the emergency room, the quicker I can bring you, we, the staff of any emergency room for that matter, to the cath lab to open up the artery. And what happens is, through the growing, we pass a catheter over here and get a, and we pass a wire across the obstruction, and then across the wire, we put a balloon catheter to open up the obstruction and create a little track, and then we put a stent in and open it up. Now, that whole process takes anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes. Now, there's two times that are involved. One was the time it took you to get from Willcrest and Memorial here to the hospital. The second time was from the door of the hospital to the cath lab, to the balloon catheter across the obstructed artery. The national standard is 90 minutes, and in our hospital, our average is 60 minutes. So it's absolutely critical for you to get to the emergency room as quickly as possible so that way we can take care of it. So if you add 20 minutes to the roughly 21 minutes that we have here, it would have taken us roughly 40 minutes to stop your heart attack. And the purpose of stopping the heart attack is to preserve as much of the heart muscle as it is that we can possibly preserve for your longevity and good health. And I'll be discussing with you in more detail this whole process that I just showed you right now. Thanks.